How to deal with complex algorithms?
When we program with text, we have decomposition. When we program with Drakon, we have also decomposition, but in addition, we have a special feature of Drakon, which is called silhouette. Let me show you how decomposition works first. Imagine that we have a large function. We add some code. And then we add more, and then we add more, and this continues until our function becomes unreadable. It does not fit on one screen anymore, and it becomes pretty lengthy. The standard approach, which we use in Drakon as well, is to extract some parts of this large algorithm into a smaller functions, like this. We select part of the algorithm, then we cut it, and we create a new function. Let's call it part one, and then we paste it here. Then we go back, select the next several icons, cut them, and paste into a new diagram. Let's call this one part two. And then again. Part three. Now we need to call this new smaller function from the main one. This is how decomposition works in Drakon. Sometimes these smaller functions do not get called from other places, so we cannot actually enjoy code reuse here. In such situations, silhouette could help. The problem with decomposition is binding, and in this case it means sending values as arguments to functions. For example, like this, and returning values. Let me show you how we could split a large algorithm using Drakon. We convert this diagram into a silhouette. Silhouette consists of several parts called branches. Let's give these branches some human names, and then move the code from these smaller functions. Now, let us take a look at the structure of a silhouette. First, we have the header of the diagram, as usual, and then we have several branches. Each branch has a header, a body, and an end. The end, the address icon, points to the next branch, in this case to part two. Here we also start at the top, go down, and then this address icon points at the part three branch. A common convention is to arrange branches so that they go from left to right. However, it is possible to change the order of the branches. It is also possible to repeat one or more branches several times. In this case, we have a silhouette loop. We have one more advantage with silhouette, besides that we do not need to pass arguments between these smaller parts of the diagram. If we take a look at the headers of the branches, we will notice that they are aligned at the top of the diagram. Because of this, the reader of the diagram does not need to investigate and study, read the whole diagram. They only have to skim over the top of it to understand the general idea. behind the algorithm. Let's take a look at some real life example. For example, quick sort algorithm. Here, in the first branch, we analyze the input, and depending on the length of the array, we proceed accordingly. We do not need to sort an empty array on an array that has only one element. We return immediately. If the length is just 2, we have a simple case, which is expressed as a separate branch. If we have a long enough array, we cannot get away with a simple case anymore. So we need to do the proper quick sorting. So we go to the partition stage. Here we partition the array into two parts. And then we recurse. We quick sort the two parts and then we put them together. So the reader could take a look at the top part of the silhouette diagram and already understand what it does. First, we analyze the input. We get away with a simple case if we get lucky, or we need to first partition the array and then we need to recurse. Let us imagine we need to read a file that has a certain structure. This file has a header, it has a body that consists of one or more sections, and then in the end of the file there is a footer. We can reflect this structure in a silhouette diagram. Here I could put some code that, for example, reads from the stream, parse, put the parse values in some memory structure, and so on. Then we proceed with the body. And in the end, we read footer, and then we, for example, save footer. But in our case, the body of the file could contain more than one section. Let's use a silhouette loop to reflect this. So instead of using an action icon, we will use a question icon. If we have read the body section, we proceed as normal with this read body section branch. But if what we have gotten is not a body section, it must be a footer. So we skip directly to the footer. Let me point this address icon to the footer. And this one to the read body section. Again, I need to replant this here. Read footer, right. Note these dark triangles. These are cycle marks. Drakon.Tech automatically detects cycles or loops in a silhouette diagram and marks them with these dark triangles. So we try to read the body section, and if the read operation has succeeded, let me delete this one. We parse the section, we save it, and then we repeat until the read operation fails and what we have is probably a footer. Then we proceed with the footer. Drakon has two types of diagrams, primitive and silhouette. Primitive is good only for small and simple algorithms, but for real life algorithms, for real life programs, silhouette is the recommended type of diagram.